Hi there. In this video, we'll be talking about a very nice feature called Text on a Path. I've got this simple listing made for you in which we're going to learn two ways to add a curve to type on. So let's learn how to do it. In the first way, we're going to use the ellipse tool. So let's grab it from the toolbar and let's make an ellipse as illustrated. We don't need a perfect circle for this one. Using the selection tool, let's drag the ellipse to touch the corners of the image in order to get a perfect alignment. Once happy with the alignment, let's add a stroke color to our ellipse. Now grab the erase tool, which sits under the pencil tool. Let me zoom in. And using the erase tool, just brush it over the corner to sever the top from the bottom on the left. Now do it on the right as well. Basically, we don't want the curve on top of the image, so we need to remove that by detaching that portion of the ellipse using the eraser tool. All right, now select the bottom of the ellipse and delete it. Drag the top away from the image a bit for it to have some breathing space. Go to the type tool and click it for a second to reveal the type on a path tool and select it. Now click once on the path and you shall find the blinking cursor. Don't worry, even if the cursor appears on the right, we'll fix that soon enough. Let's type in Odyssey Water Sport Association and then select the text and center align it from the alignment options on top. With the text still selected, let's change the font to Marketing Script or any other font that makes you happy. Let's also increase the font size to about 30 points. Now go to Type and then type on a path and click Options. From the pop-up menu, check the flip box and your text will be readable. If you want the text a little above the baseline, select the Descender option from the Align drop-down menu. If you want it under the line, select Ascender. Selecting Center will center align it to the path, so let's keep it center aligned. Let's reduce the spacing on either sides of the path, which will give more character space to your text. Try these effects on top to further customize your text so you have rainbow, which is the current setting. Change it to other effects to see how they are displayed, and this is up to you as a designer how you want your text to be displayed. Some options do make the text go crazy though, so I'm going to stick to rainbow. The two-path option on the right will make slight changes to the baseline alignment of your text, so pick the one that suits the best. I'm going to stick to center and hit OK. Obviously, we wouldn't want our text to have this curvy line striking through it, so to get rid of it, just change the path weight to 0 and it shall be gone. Let's change our font to a slightly thicker one, so I'm going to select it and change it to Marketing Script Inline. Perfect. You've just learned one way to create the curve to add your text to. Now let's move to the second way. Let's delete the text. Let's drag a guide from the ruler on the left and drop it at the left edge of the image. Similarly, drop another one on the right edge of the image. Now drag one guide from the ruler on top and place it as illustrated. We've done this to establish the points on both sides as we'll need them now. Grab the pen tool and click the left point where both guides meet. Now click the center point at some elevation and without releasing the mouse, drag it to the right, holding shift for a straight line. Release the shift button and click the right point where both the guides meet and your curve should be made. Add black color to your path and there you have it ready. Now rest of the steps should be easy for you as we've done it already. So grab the text on a path tool and click once on the path and start typing your text. Center align the text, change the font to lobster, and also update the font size to 30 points. Actually, let's change it to 32 points. Go to type and then type on a path and select options. Center align the text to the path and also reduce the spacing on the side to give your text some breathing space and hit OK. Lastly, change the path width to 0 point to make it vanish. Hit the W key for a preview, and you've successfully learned both the ways to add a curve and type text on a path in InDesign. All right, guys, that concludes our session today. I hope you've enjoyed it and have learned something new from it. So do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye, and thanks for watching.